Welcome to NLK Group of Schools. Dear student, today we are going to study more on HTML. But before going through more on HTML, we should understand what is the exact definition of HTML and why is it needed. So HTML is full form of HTML. If you are talking about HTML, then full form of HTML is hypertext markup language. Then the question arises here, what is hypertext? In a HTML, what is hypertext? Student, hypertext is a simple, it is a simple text, or we can say it is a ordinary text. It is a ordinary text but having a special feature. It is a ordinary text but having a special feature. And what type of special feature it has? It has a special feature of linking another documents or linking another text. So while we are talking about linking of another documents and linking of another pages, just because if you generally visit the website, if you generally visit the website on the internet, you have seen there are, if you visit a website, NLK's website, then you have seen there is a number of text over here, home and about. These kind of text written in a one page of website, the moment you click on that particular hypertext, and the hypertext, how can you recognize that it is a hypertext or it is a ordinary or a simple text? So basically, when you click on the hypertext is a clickable. That means it having the property of clickable. ये click होता है, it is a clickable. So when you click on that particular text, it will jump to the another page or relevant or related page of that particular text. If we are going to another page of that particular text, so simply we have to click on that text. Then we will jump to the another page. Suppose that here is another hypertext written over here. Then after clicking that hypertext, we jump to the another page. So as you studied before, website is a collection of the web pages. So web pages are interlinked with each other. Web pages are linked with each other. So how is it linked with each other? It is linked with each other just because of hypertext markup language. Because it has the linking syntax so that we can link the pages from one to another. Now, this is a hypertext just because it has a special feature of linking pages. Now, coming to the markup language. Why it is called the markup language? Student, if you study about some other languages, what is basically, just you have to know one more thing. What is code? What is coding? Basically, coding is a syntax, or coding is a medium of communication with system. So we must understand the coding, and we can create a pythons, python? Is in your course python language and some more other languages. So coding is a scripting language. It is a medium to communicate with the system so that we can fulfill our task through the system. So these are the languages. But HTML is not a language, it is a markup language. Why is it called the markup language? Because it has a predefined tag. It has a predefined tag. Or it has a tag. So markup basically to mark the text, to tag the text to completion of that particular task in the coding. And also it doesn't have the decision making controls. Why it is called the markup language? Because it doesn't have decision making controls. Now we can ask, what is the decision making controls? If you have studied in Python, there is a statement, if to create a condition. If this is a condition, after completion of this condition you can perform that particular task. So this is a decision making system controls. If ladder, why and for, there is some looping statements also. So these decision making controls in that particular these particular languages like C, C++, Java, Python and many more. But in the HTML you can simply create a static web pages so that you can just simply see that pages. These pages are not dynamic, but also we can create it dynamically after adding some scripting languages like JavaScript and some other. But we can create HTML pages as a static pages on the web page, on the website. So HTML is used to create a web page on the internet, on the, so that you can see through the browser. Now coming to, so in the website, when you visit the website, you can see the various pages, various web pages of a particular website. So there is a number of the images also in that particular page. Have you ever wondered how it is inserted in that particular web page? So now we will study how to insert the images in website. So here we will discuss inserting images in HTML document. The topic is inserting images in HTML document. So here is the syntax. You must have to know about the syntax of inserting images. So syntax is, tag is img. This is the tag we must have to know. And here src is a attribute. Image is a tag. Image is a tag in which a attribute. Attribute having the value. So what is exactly meaning of SRC? SRC meaning of source, where pictures are. SRC is the source where we can take the picture. SRC is the source which can take the pictures from your system device or from the internet. So here we write the path from which we have taken the picture. Suppose that in a seed drive there is a My Document folder and there is an image. Image name is image and the format is JPEG. The format is JPEG. So this is the full syntax. This is the full syntax as you can see. So you have to write this syntax in a HTML document to insert the images on your HTML document. Now, in image, there are the number of the attributes. In an image tag, we can write a number of the attributes. First is SRC, as we have studied here. Second is alt. Alt is basically for the alternative text or picture. Suppose that for some reason this picture cannot be uploaded, cannot be seen, then there is another option so that we can show some alternative text or pictures over here. So we can write a alt. So here we can simply write here alt and write sorry, picture is not opened. This kind of message you can type. Sorry for inconvenience. So you can write these attributes. Now third is you can set a border of that picture also. So border, you can write the attribute border and give the value of border. Here we can write the value is 2 of the border. Now another attributes are alignment. Why alignment is used? Alignment is an attribute of image. It is used to justify the picture or the adjustment of picture on a proper position. So we can write align equals to, you can write here right, left, up, down or center. I am writing here right. So this is the whole proper syntax or tag of image to insert the image in a HTML document. Now we will see the full coding of HTML.